I think I've taken the longest shower of my life after first going in the chili wong. You see people upstream basically defecating in the river. You have all manner of garbage floating past you, sometimes mattresses, sometimes dead rats. And you're never quite sure what you're stepping on. I was first drawn to Jakarta, Indonesia, because it's really just this fascinating confluence of people, of city, of flooding. But what I found from working in Jakarta for a couple of years is that a lot of these flooding problems, it's really complications from garbage that's clogging these flood canals and flood reservoirs. All these issues kind of come together to create some very, very intense flooding, which for a civil engineer, you know, this is awesome. Upon looking into this issue of all the garbage that's clogging pumps, reducing the volume of canals and reservoirs, I quickly found there was very little data available on the amount of garbage in Jakarta, much less any data as to where this garbage is coming from and how it varied spatially and temporally. So what I'm working on is a system to measure this garbage using cameras and some computer vision algorithms. The technology I'm using for this research is really the same technology that you have in your cell phone camera. For instance, when you take a photo of someone, how does the camera in your cell phone detect someone's face? These algorithms work on the principle of basically detecting contrast between different parts of the image. So the contrast between a white plastic bag floating in the river and the darker water of the Chili Wong River. The algorithms will detect the outline of the shape, allowing me then to determine that this shape that is detected is indeed garbage. From one camera over 2 to 3 weeks, I typically end up with 10 to 20,000 photos to sort through. And this is taking a photo from 6 in the morning till 6 at night every 2 to 3 seconds. To install these cameras in the places I need them, I've climbed trees over the Chili Wong. I've scaled on the underside of bridges to install these cameras. Some pretty pretty nerve-wracking situations now and then to get these cameras in place, but anything for the data. The algorithms I'm using are able to detect, I'd say, 90% of the garbage that passes through a given image frame or given video. The biggest issue, though, is making sure the garbage isn't double counted, right? So between successive video frames, you're not detecting the garbage when it first appears and also when it's still leaving the image. So I'm working still to ensure that I'm only counting the garbage once. With the data I'm gathering, we can begin addressing and begin targeting cleanup efforts on the communities that are throwing the most garbage into the Chili Wong. This is done by simply putting a camera upstream of the community and putting a camera downstream of the community, and then basically measuring the difference between the amount of garbage detected from the upstream camera and the downstream camera. The government has very limited resources with which to put to waste management in these poor areas. So if we can say that this community is throwing the most garbage in the Chili Wong, if we put a dumpster or have regular waste management collection at this community, we should expect to see a fairly large decrease in the amount of overall garbage downstream from this point on the river. I see garbage as a very kind of underappreciated topic of research. It's interesting because every city has an enormous amount of garbage that everyone generates every single day, but there's so little data on this garbage and so many people paying any attention to it. The idea that you just throw it out your back door and it's gone is a very narrow-minded idea. And I'm kind of interested in the back end of the garbage question, right? Where does the garbage come from? Where does it go? How do we handle it eventually? These are all kind of central questions to this research that have not been resolved, for the most part, in cities around the world.
Virtual reality technology has been established for many years, and it's only recently that the public has really started to hear more about it, as people are starting to recognize that you can actually